Hey everybody, welcome to another random game Unshrinking. I'm not sure this is actually even a game, to be honest with you. What I have here is a CD-ROM comic book called Aquaman War of the Water Worlds, which is published by DC in 1996, as you can see on the bottom here. And the form factor of this is basically like a comic book, and it comes like polybagged, like some comic books used to come back in the 90s, which was extremely annoying. You wanted to read the comic, and it was already sealed, basically, and if you opened it, people said it would damage the value of the comic, so you couldn't open it and you couldn't read it. That was a fad, which, thankfully, seems to have gone away. And it says it's a first edition, so in case, you know, comic book collectors like first editions, this is the first edition, I'm sure the only edition. The picture on the front looks pretty cool, but if you look at the back, it's basically, looks like they took animation out of the old Aquaman cartoon from the 60s. So, it says source material from DC Comics classic 1960s animated television shows. So, this is probably not that great, I'm guessing, but it's still sort of cool. I like comics. I like computer games of some, and things that are like games. And Aquaman is pretty underrated. It says here, Aquaman springs to life on CD-ROM. Aquaman and his allies find themselves confronted by an army of super villains, who unleash a devastating suction machine that captures the creatures in Aquaman's watery realm. Will Aquaman be able to save the Earth's oceans? Multimedia action in every panel. So, anyway, it's probably really silly. I've also seen a Superman title that's, I think it's called Superman the Mysterious Mr. Mist or something like that. But let's open it up and see what's in it. I'll try just cutting the top with these scissors, but I bet you I'm going to have to do more than that. This is what I would do if it was actually a comic book, and I was trying to open it up and read it. But this seems like a pretty rigid piece of cardboard, and I bet you it's not going to come out of this plastic so easily. But we'll see. Ah, they tricked me. It's actually, there's another seal here, so that what I just did was completely worthless. All right, I'm still going to try to cut it. Cut take two. I'm losing the CD-ROM super value, so we'll just have to remember what a wonderful value it indeed was. All right, let's see if I can get it out now. Okay, like I said, it's pretty tight fit here. This plastic is probably going to be garbage at the end of the day. I feel like just by taking it out, I'm gonna rip it. Oh, there we go, okay. All right, so I got that off, and now it's shrink-wrapped again. All right, well, this is fun. This is obviously some kind of torture device rather than being a fun game or whatnot. Let's see if I can use the scissors to get this thing going. Again, the trick is due to the ripping actually. Cardboard. All right, there we go. What's going to be inside? My guess is a blank CD and nothing else. Let's see. Okay, well, I was close. There's a CD. And apparently there's three other comics in the series. Like I said, there's Superman Mysterious Mr. Abyss. I've seen that one. There's also Batman Partners in Peril and Superboy Spies from Outer Space. That sounds interesting, especially the Superboy one. Anyway, that's what's inside here. I'm going to try to see if I can see what this looks like, if it'll actually run on my machine. So a lot of people have asked me to include gameplay footage in these videos. The reason why I haven't done it until now is because it takes so freaking long to get these games to work sometimes. It takes way longer to make these videos if you're trying to get capture gameplay footage, probably about 10 times longer. In this case, the game came with a version of QuickTime 2.1.1 that basically just hung DOSBox completely, and it couldn't get it to run. It just crashed the whole thing. So I had to go find a 16-bit version of QuickTime 2.1.2 that would actually play, that would actually run properly in DOSBox. And I'll put the link to that in the notes below, but that's what took this so damn long for this to work. Okay, so now I'm going to try to actually run this title and see what we come up with. It takes a while to run just because it's loading off a CD.
And first, we have to unfortunately deal with this. I guess this is a QuickTime thing, I'm assuming. We're getting all these wonderful patterns to test for optimal display performance. I'm guessing this has to happen when you install QuickTime just now for the first time, but not really sure. In any case, bear with us another couple seconds. Okay, so far so good. And now we're at this menu screen, which I really had a hard time figuring out what the heck to do. There's not a lot of information here. There wasn't really a manual. I guess here you can skip forward to different pages of the comic. Not too many pages. There's 22 pages, it looks like, in total. There's manual mode, I assume, lets you click, and automatic mode, which I assume will just play it all like a movie. But I tried to go manual mode, and I hit launch comic to see where this takes us. And basically, it's looks like a cartoon from the 60s that they made into a comic on the screen with audio for music, but no actual voice. Not sure what the point of it is, really. Is everything ready for our plan? Yes, Skrrg, but first you must deliver what you promised to us. Excellent. Here are the whereabouts of the upper sea creatures you desire. Take what you need to sustain life in your oceans, but remember our deal. Blah, blah, blah. Now, Aquaman, king of the seven seas, alerted to the strange happenings by a sonic sensory device, rushes to the sea with his young companion, Aqualad.
Jumping jellyfish, what's that, Aquaman?
Looks like it is. It's a suction tube. Who cares?
But who? What? Why? No, Tusky, stay away from that. Tusky, watch out. Whoosh. It's got me too.
Basically, this is a cartoon where you do your own voices. I mean, again, they just took the 60s cartoon. I mean, why do we really need this? I guess it would have sort of been cool if they would have put the cartoon into a real paper comic, but what's the point of doing it in a video when I could just actually watch the 60s cartoon? I mean, I guess I could have fun making my own voices, but aside from that, there's not much here. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I do want to quit. Okay, so now let's see what the actual 60s cartoon looked like originally.
King of the seven seas, alerted to the strange happenings by a sonic sentry device, rushes to the scene with his young companion, Aqualad.
Sir, mounted earthlings approach.
Draw them in if they come close.
Jumping jellyfish. What's that, Aquaman?
Looks like it is. It's a suction tube.
But who? What? Why?
I don't know the answers, Aqualad, but I aim to find out. Let's go, Storm, topside.
No, Tusky, stay away from that. Tusky, watch out. Mumbling mantis. It's got me.
An interesting specimen. Dehydrate him.
Help! Aquaman! Help!
Okay, Tadpole, let's go!
Alright, so I guess the question is, if you had the original video, why in the world would you ever want this CD-ROM product? And I think the answer clearly is, you wouldn't. There's no point to this at all. Even back when they made this, in the 90s, they could have made a video CD if they wanted to get this classic animation in the hands of the public. Instead, they just put out this thing, which, I mean, it's some effort on the part of the developers, but I really don't see the point at all. Now that I've seen this, I certainly am not going to waste my time or money on Superman, Batman, or Superboy. I'm sure they're all just based on original 60s animation. I could just go grab those as well. And I wouldn't recommend any of you guys waste your time on any of this stuff, either. I mean, luckily it only cost me $5, but still, hopefully you guys will learn from this, from my mistake, and not waste your own time on it as well. Really, just a waste of time, to be honest. I don't like to criticize developers, but in this case, I hope they got a good paycheck. I'm not sure what else the point of this was. And here they are. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please leave me a comment. Please like, please subscribe, tell your friends. If you want the CD, let me know. Maybe I'll give it to you for free. Have a great day, everybody.